One School Global, we'd like to take the time to wish all our students and staff a happy International Women's Day.
Really, Paul? Standing up there wishing the girls or the women that attend your schools happy International Women's Day when we know that the school that the cults run and own, that is One School Global, that is owned and run by the Exclusive Brethren, or as they've recently rebranded, the Plymouth Brethren Christian Church, is but a cult. Nobody from outside is allowed to attend these schools, and me, as a former student of the MET / One School Global schooling, was not allowed to further my career, to go to university. None of the kids there are, so there's no happy International Women's Day. The women of all are the least happy in that environment. From my experience growing up, they were oppressed. Women weren't allowed to have a career, let alone university. They were sent to work and then married off into homes, usually with no choice over who they married. So really, Paul, is it a happy International Women's Day at One School Global? But don't take my word for it. Let's look at some of One School Global reviews from former teachers. With a quick little Google, you can have a look at how toxic an environment this school that is owned by a cult is to work in and how they do not support women. Here's the first one. Female staff are not allowed to wear pants, must be skirts below the knees, sleeves to the elbow, classes are small, often have extra ES hours, schools go from grade 3 to 12, the girls do not go in on to further education, they often work for family businesses until marriage. And then the kids believe they're going to hell and there isn't a lot of respect. Rules are around books, a lot of rules around books and technology, because the cult obviously limit that, because they, heaven forbid, you have a perspective outside of the cult. And let's have a look at another one. Here's another one where it says that the schools are run by a closed religious community. Teachers are limited in what they can teach and the students are not allowed to go to university, making it feel like your job is redundant. No job security as people disappear overnight with no explanation. I can back this one up from my own experience, because as a teenager going to these high schools, teachers would disappear overnight. All of a sudden there'd be a replacement teacher and no one would know where your English teacher went, or your maths teacher, or your science teacher. So there is no happy International Women's Day for the women in that cult, for the girls studying in that cult, particularly in the schools. And for teachers, as you can see, there is no joy in teaching there. And for my HSC year, the year of the class of 2009, there was a girl in my class who was extremely brilliant, and she was the top scoring student for the state for English, for standard English, and she was not allowed, the teachers were forbidden to tell her this, and I'm only just finding this out, she was not allowed to accept her award in person, because obviously she would then have the idea to further her career. So they did everything to limit your possibilities of furthering your career, and in particular, if you were a woman.